ways out of no way. He can do anything. He can make ways out of no way. We serve a mighty God. 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 Thank you for being mighty. 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 Thank you for being mighty God. 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 You won every battle for me. You won every battle for me. You won every battle for me. And now I have victory. You won every battle for me. You won every battle for me. You won every battle for me. And I have victory. You won every battle for me. You won every battle for me. You won every battle for me. And I have victory. You won every battle for me. You won every battle for me. You won every battle for me. And I have victory. And I have victory. And I have victory. And I have victory. Give him a wave offering. Yeah. Give him a wave offering. Offer your wave. Say, hey, Daddy. Thank you for being mighty. God is so good, isn't he? I'm so excited about today. Woo! God is in this place. He's here. God is here. And I'm excited about him not thinking it was robbery to come and be with us today. But I'm not going to be before you long. I just want to give you a little bit of what God gave me. And so I'm going to go real quick to the Word of God. If you have your Bibles, you can go with me really quickly. I'm going to go to Genesis chapter 1. I'm going to the beginning. Genesis chapter 1.
Genesis 1.
And we're going to read at verse 27, well, 26 through 28.
Hasta el 28.
Genesis 1, 26 through 28. And it reads. Then God said,
entonces Dios dijo,
let us make man in our image.
Hay que hacer al hombre a nuestra imagen.
According to our likeness.
Con la que nosotros nos gusta.
Let them have dominion over the fish of the sea.
Que tengan dominio a los peces.
Over the birds of the air.
Sobre las aves en el aire.
And over the cattle.
Y todas las vacas.
Over all the earth.
Toda la tierra.
And over every creeping thing that creeps on the earth.
Todas las criaturas que hay en la tierra.
So God created man in his image.
Entonces Dios hizo al hombre a su imagen.
In the image of God,
la
he created him.
En la imagen de Dios lo hizo a él.
Male and female.
Hombre y mujer.
He created them.
Los creyó a ellos.
Then God blessed them.
Y luego Dios los bendició.
And God said to them.
Y Dios le dijo a ellos.
Be fruitful and multiply.
Multiplícate.
Fill the earth and subdue.
Llena la tierra y sigue.
Have dominion over the fish of the sea.
Ten dominión en los en las aves.
Over the birds of the air.
En las aves del cielo.
And over every living thing that moves on the earth.
Y en todas las cosas que viven en la tierra.
And if I should use for a topic or a subject, a theme,
si usara un tópico, algo,
it would be
sería
my identity.
mi identidad.
Has given me grace.
Mi identidad me ha dado
and
gracia.
Favor.
Por favor.
Father, in the mighty name of Jesus.
En el nombre de Jesús.
Father, I thank you for
Padre,
this day that you have given us all.
Que tú has hecho, Dios.
I thank you for your spirit, God, that you allow to abide in this place.
Viene aquí, nos llena
Father, I ask, oh God, that you, God, fill me up and pour into me the words that you want me to speak for your people, that they understand their identity today, oh God, and that they walk in the grace and the favor that you have given them. Father, I remove myself so that you may live in me. God, you speak through me like rivers of living water, and allow it to flow, God, and allow it to manifest in the people, that they may live out this word and do it, God, so that the world may see who you are. In Jesus Christ's name, amen and amen. Amen. You may take your seat. My identity has given me grace and favor. And as I was reading this word, I saw where it says, God, this Bible don't want to stay open, so I'm going to close it. Must be a sign. But it says that God spoke to somebody, because he said, let us make man in our image. We know that when it says, let us is plural, and our is plural. And he said, we got to make them like us. So I began to research and I begin to look and find out, God, who was you talking to? Because if you were first and you were the beginning and somebody was here with you for you to talk, who are you talking to? God says, first and foremost, I birthed a baby by the Spirit. So I said, okay, that baby didn't come until the New Testament. God said, listen at what I said. I birthed a baby through the Spirit. And when the baby was here, the baby came out to be me in the flesh through the Spirit. I said, okay. God said, so if I made and birthed my son through the Spirit, I had to been talking to the Spirit within me to say, let us go and make man in my image. So I said, okay, so you talking to you? Because you was here first. He said, I'm talking to me through the Spirit. And it said that when he created man, he created man by the dirt and the spit and turned it into clay. And he formed man. But man was still dirt and clay and flesh. Man did not become the image of God until the breath was blown into man. So, if I'm going to make man in my image, I had to blow the spirit of me in man for him to be like me. So I said, okay, God, so you're telling me that you made us through your spirit. Yes. Okay, what does that have to do with my identity? So I went and looked up identity. Identity in Webster's dictionary is being oneself and not another. Listen. Identity means to be oneself and not another. Okay. So I looked it up in the Hebrew. Y'all know I like Hebrew. Hebrew word identity is sisos. And it means the very breath and the soul. Did y'all catch that? The very breath and the soul. Sisos is identity in Hebrew, and it means the very breath and the soul. So it means that God gave us our identity through the breath, the spirit that he blew in us. So my identity came through the spirit of God, and not only the spirit of God, but through my sisos, the breath that breathed on me. So I said, okay, God, so you mean to tell me that you made me in the identity of you, and so I am now spirit. I now have a spirit abiding on the inside of me. I am now the identity of God. So with me having the identity, you told me that if I was to walk in your image because you created me. When you created me, you said it was perfect. It's good. And so when you told me that you created me, you then told me to do some things while I was here. Okay, God. I got an identity. I'm your image now. I'm giving me. I'm giving you grace, and I'm giving you favor. There are some things that we are to do on this earth in the identity of God. Let's read what they are. I'm trying to go back to that Bible, but he said no. First, I created them. Who is them? Male and female. Male, man, female, woman. So you gave me an identity like you, but it says he created them. How can she be him when he created us in the image of God? Some may say, I can't be him because I'm a she, but the spirit has no form or no image. The spirit has no sexual orientation. It ain't no male, it ain't female. The spirit is whatever you are when it abides in you. So your identity is what you are through the spirit of God. And so while he said, I created them, they were perfect. Now there are some things I need you to do. And because of your identity, this is why you get grace and favor when you do what I tell you to do. First, he says, be fruitful. Be fruitful. My identity, my image now tells me to be fruitful. Fruitful means to produce good and useful and make useful results. I'm living in an abundance. I'm fruitful. I'm living in an abundance now. I'm making good use. I'm not just here on the surface just doing. I'm being fruitful now. And a lot of people may say, be fruitful and multiply mean to have a whole bunch of children. Just start spitting out babies everywhere. Yeah, he said do that too. But to be fruitful and to be multiplied, to be fruitful and to be able to produce good things, you've got to be good. Because you can only sow what you are. And you're going to reap exactly what you sow. So to be a good use and to produce and be fruitful, you have to be good to be fruitful. Because anything that's not good is dead. And if it's dead, it can't produce fruit. So I have to be good. The spirit that's on the inside of me has to be good to be able to be fruitful. What am I fruitful in? I'm fruitful in my love. What am I fruitful in? I'm fruitful in my patience. What am I fruitful in? I'm fruitful in how I give. What am I fruitful in? I'm fruitful in how I act. I'm fruitful in how I speak. I'm fruitful in how I toil. I'm fruitful in how I work. I'm fruitful.
comfortable in how I am, who I am. Because he says that the harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. And because we have been fruitful and we made so many, it's time for us to be fruitful in going and getting the many. So first he says, your image has caused you to be fruitful. It caused you to be good. Because he said that after he created man, it was good. Everything that he did after creating it, he said, it was good. So to be fruitful is to be producing good things. Not only that, he said, multiply. Now I know you might say, wait a minute, fruitful is like multiplying, eh? Multiply means to increase greatly in number. So fruitful is to produce good, but as I produce good, I increase in that good. But I can only increase and produce good if I'm in my true identity. I can't produce if I'm not good. If I don't have the image, which is the spirit, because we now get the image of God by the spirit of God, because that's what was given to man to become man and to become life. I had to have the spirit. So if I don't have the spirit, I'm not producing and I'm not multiplying. So that cuts off my favor. Because there are five things that God told man to do. Five means grace and favor. So if he told me to do five things, he was telling me I had the power to do these things through the identity of what he has given me. And my identity has given me grace and favor. So if I'm to multiply and I'm to be fruitful, I have to have the spirit. Not only that, he says, I have to replenish. What does replenish mean? Replenish means to make full or complete again. To make full or complete again. Wait a minute. To make full or complete again. So I have the power. My identity has given me the power to make complete and full again. It has given me the power to not lack. It has given me the power to live in abundance. It has given me the power to increase in what I am. It has given me the power to take back which is lacking and full and completed. It has given me the power to speak those things as be not as though they were. Because whatever is lacking, I can speak fullness and it's there. My identity has given me this power. But if you don't have your identity and you don't walk in it, you don't have the grace and the favor to do it.
Lord, come on, yes, Lord.
I hope y'all catching this.
Yes. Come on.
So not only did he say fruitful, multiply, and replenish, he said subdue.
Jesus.
Subdue. To conquer or to bring into subjection. Do you see how much power we have with our identity? To conquer or to make something come into subjection. I have the power to not only conquer, but I have the power to be more than a conqueror. I have the power to make what the enemy tried to do come into subjection of me because of my identity. I have the power to make those things that the enemy tries to blow in my face, that very stone that was talked about today, I have the power to make the stone come into subjection unto me and move out of my way. Because he said that when you pray, when you have praying hands and praying mouths and praying spirit and a praying knee, you got the power to speak to the mountain and tell the mountain to be thy removed. Because now the mountain has to come under subjection unto you. But if you don't have your true identity, which is the spirit of God, ain't no stone moving.
That's the preach. Jesus.
That stone gonna stay right there. Because my identity gives me the power to say move. My identity gives me the power to subdue. My identity gives me the power to increase. My identity gives me the power to produce. My identity gives me the power to restore. My identity is doing this.
Lord.
Not only did he say subdue, but he said, and have dominion.
Jesus.
Have dominion. Dominion means to rule. Dominion means to have power.
Significa tener poder.
I don't know if y'all caught it in praise and worship. But when that boy right there said, we want your power.
Necesitamos tu poder.
Send your power.
Send tu poder.
I said, Lord, give me dominion.
Yes.
I want to be able to walk and go anywhere I want to go and be able to rule. And not the devil has the authority to rule me. Because in the garden with Adam and Eve, the enemy, the serpent, came and he was deceitful. He was sneaky. He came and spoke when they already had dominion. They already had power. They already could subdue. They already could replenish. They already could produce. They already had multiplication. They already were fruitful. And they allowed the enemy to come in because they forgot what their identity was. They forgot who they were. Because their identity that they were created in told them they had grace and favor. They could do anything they wanted to do. They could have what they wanted to have. He told them what to eat, what not to eat, what to do and what not to do. But he told them they had dominion to rule. God has given us power. God has given us favor. God has given us the strength to endure anything. But we haven't. And we're lacking. And we're going through. And we're struggling because we don't have our identity. Because we think our identity is, I'm a prophet.
Soy un profeta.
We think our identity is, I'm an evangelist.
Soy un evangélico.
My identity is my title. My identity is what I want to be when I grow up. We have the power.
Tenemos el poder.
That we don't have to go and work for people. Some of y'all might think I'm crazy. But what you go to school for? To own business. He said
dominion.
He said subdue. He said replenish. He said be fruitful. He said multiply. He ain't never said gonna work for somebody. You have the power to own your own businesses. When you have dominion, your identity that you have from God has given you the favor to go to school, get a degree, and open it up yourself. What identity do you care?
¿Quién eres tú?
Who are you?
¿Quién eres tú?
Because my identity tells me,
dice a mí,
that when I speak,
cuando yo hable las cosas,
it's gotta happen.
Tiene que pasar.
Because once Adam and Eve lost their identity, they were kicked out of the garden. Jesus. No more in plenty. No more in peace. No more in favor. No more in grace. But now I'm living in lack.
Soy flojo.
Now I'm living in poverty.
Ahora soy pobre.
Now I'm living
ahora
from paycheck to paycheck.
Soy cheque tras cheque.
Now I'm living
ahora
in sickness and pain.
Estoy enfermo y en dolor.
Jesus.
Now I'm living where I can't make ends meet.
No hago nada.
Now I'm living where I'm decreasing.
Yo no soy nada.
Now I'm living to where the enemy now has subjection over me.
Oh God, come on.
Now I'm living to where I don't even know when I'm going and where I'm coming and what I got to do the next day. But all I know is that I have lost my grace and my favor because I no longer have the identity of God.
Jesus.
And God is telling me to tell somebody today to get your identity back.
Jesus. Yes, Lord.
Because now we are in a place where so many is going through an identity crisis. They don't know who they are anymore. They don't know what their names are. They don't know who they are and what they've been created to do. All they know is I am this person. But my identity comes through the Spirit of God. The very thing that's on the inside of me was birthed through the Spirit of God. I know it sounds crazy, but how do you not understand that your identity comes from the Spirit? When Mary was pregnant, even before she was pregnant, she did not lay with Joseph. But something was birthed.
Nació.
Something was birthed into Mary.
Algo nació en María.
Mary had purpose.
Ella tenía propósito.
But not only did she have purpose, she had an identity.
Tenía una identidad.
Because her identity is what caused her to get the favor to birth the purpose.
Darnos el propósito.
Because when Gabriel went to Mary in the garden, he told her, you found favor with God. It was your identity that he saw. He saw that you were good. He saw that you could be fruitful. He saw that you could multiply. He saw that you could replenish. Number one, you was in a garden where fruits are. He saw that you could subdue. Because you didn't allow the enemy to come up against you. When the angel came to you, you said, wait, me, you choose me. Yes, because you put the devil in subjection that you never laid with anybody before you got married.
Dios es Dios.
I looked at you and I saw that you had
dominion.
Because in the beginning, before Mary, Eve was created in the image. So because she kept the identity of what God created Eve to be, you found favor with me, girl. Now I can give you purpose. God is looking for some people to keep your identity so you can have some grace and faith. God is looking for some people that can stand up to the devil and say, I subdue you.
Yes, Lord. Jesus.
God is looking for some people that can go in dead places and bring about life and say, replenish. Jesus. God is looking for some people that can go to the hospital and say, be healed. Jesus. only done through your identity.
Solo con tu identidad.
You can only have it if you have the Spirit of God.
Tienes el Espíritu de Dios.
Because
porque
the angel said, Mary.
El ángel le dijo a María.
Because Mary said,
María dijo,
how is this going to happen, Gabriel?
Gabriel?
How is this purpose just going to just pop up?
Sí, ¿cómo van a ser el bebé?
Said the Spirit of God is going to overtake
you.
The Spirit of God is getting ready to overtake you. And on her journey to see Elizabeth, thank you. It said that on her journey, the Spirit overtook her. The glory. The glory. Clothed her. The glory covered her. And it said that she was then pregnant with seed. She was carrying an identity. Because when now it's time for Jesus to be born, it said he had nowhere to go. There was no place for the identity. So many of us was walking around and we're not given a place for the identity to lay. The identity is just out walking, knocking. Can I come in? Can I come in?
Jesus.
Can I come in? You gotta give your identity a home. It's homeless.
Jesus.
Your house is empty.
No tiene casa.
And God is looking for somebody that wants grace and favor. God is looking for somebody that says, here, choose me. I want the identity of you. I want your image. I want to rule. I want to reign. I want to live. I want to increase. Enlarge my territory. Give me more than enough. I want to be able to live in abundance. Because the identity said, I came that you might have life and have it more abundantly. So to have the identity is to have an abundance of life. It's to have an abundance of everything that you need. And I declared that when I read this, I told God, if I lost it, I want my identity back. I want it back. Because wherever I go, I want to increase. Whatever I do, I want to subdue. Wherever I speak and whatever I speak, God, I want it to be fruitful. God, however you see fit for these feet to walk in, wherever they go, I want to rule. Because you said that you have given us this power to be able to have a sound mind and to be able to have dominion to rule. God, I'm not allowing the enemy to rule me no more. I want my identity back. Is there anybody who wants their identity? Is there anybody looking for your identity? Today is the day to get your identity so that grace and favor can be granted to you. If you know that you have been operating and you haven't been in your identity, now is the time to seek your identity back. You need to seek the Spirit of God like never before. Because when you get the Spirit of God on the inside of you, the favor and the grace that will come to your life, you'll be able to tell the devil, you can't stop me, you can't block me, you can't hinder me, you can't distract me. Because the very thing that God has told me in the beginning, that he has given me the power to be fruitful. He has given me the power to multiply. He has given me the power to replenish. He has given me the power to subdue. He has given me the power to have dominion. And I am going to walk in my identity, because the favor that is on my life has given me the number 7 of completion. And once I have the Spirit of God, I now walk in the Trinity, and the Trinity now tells me that my God is my God, my God is my provider, my God is my healer, my God is my way maker, my God is my everything, and whatever I need, I have already got it, because the Spirit that's on the inside of me has already given me grace and favor. And nothing will be able to take it from you when your identity is who you are. Your identity is who you are. This is the day. This is the time. It's happening right now. It's happening right now. The power already fell in this house today. The power already fell in this house today. Your identity already fell in this house today.
Yes, Jesus.
It is now your choice to operate in it. Because your identity says that miracles, signs, and wonders can follow me. Your identity says that I am a healer. Your identity says I am a way maker. I hope you're catching this. Because if you're in the image of God, you are a way maker. You are a way maker. Because the way maker is on the inside of you. And because he's in here, your needs will be supplied. When you have your identity, you are then able, Jesus, to bring life. Because he said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. When you have your identity, you are now living in truth. There is nothing that is attached to you that is not good. Jesus, there is nothing that is attached to you that is dead. Because when you have the identity of Jesus, he says, life I am. And when you have life, you now have the power to go to your brother. When your brother is down and out, and you can blow the breath of life into him by letting him know you are more than a conqueror. You can do all things through Christ that strengthens you. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. You can stand and live. Jesus, your identity says that greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. The world will come to you for a change. The world will come to you for deliverance. The world will come to you for peace. The world will come to you for love. But you gotta have it on the inside. Where's your identity? Where's your identity? Today is the day. Grab it. Grab it. Grab your identity. He said it this morning. Hold on to it. Put it close to your heart. Hold on to your identity. Don't let it go. Because when you do, you lose your favor.
Yes.
And you lose your grace. Because when Jesus left, he left the identity. He left the spirit. And the spirit has now given you a narrative. The very great endeavor that Adam and Eve lost, he allowed that same identity to come to fulfill what he left. That he wanted to restore you back to your identity. He loved you enough that he wanted to restore you back to your image. He loved you enough that he wanted to restore you back to your power. He loved you enough that he wanted to restore you back to your good place. Walk in your identity. Walk in your identity. Walk in your identity. Walk in your identity. If you feel that you need to regain your identity, come to this altar really quickly.